The idea that we are now a few days away from a new administration, given, as you heard from the introduction, that I have been around for a while and have had the opportunity of serving in 5 administrations, I thought I would bring that perspective to the topic today, is the issue of pandemic preparedness. And if there's one message that I want to leave with you today, is that there is no question that there will be a surprise outbreak. The thing we're extraordinarily confident about is that we are going to see this in the next few years. Thank you.
Okay, Neil, spoiler alert, you're a scientist.
Indeed.
And legally, I am required to ask you your thoughts about the coronavirus.
Oh.
And I understand you're not a virologist, you're not an immunologist, you're not an epidemiologist, but I suspect...
I'm an astrophysicist, Jim!
I suspect you have an opinion.
A point of view, I would
say. Okay,
okay. I would say. So, I'm broadly scientifically literate, but what I will say... of this virus. I think we're in the middle of a massive experiment worldwide.
And that is... And we're the guinea pigs?
Maybe. The experiment is, will people listen to scientists? In this case, referring to medical professionals?
Medical professionals.
In this particular case?
Say Anthony Fauci over at Allergy and Infectious Disease.
For example, yeah. And... are you washing your hands? And are you taking these precautions? These are warnings offered by scientists.
And for our own good.
For our own good. And it seems to me if we all listened and all paid attention, don't get freak out, right? Don't live in... A life lived in fear is a life half lived. So you don't want to... I'm just... so I'd be interesting if we all... paid attention to what scientists say, maybe the coronavirus will just blow on by with a minimum of cases. And then we kicked its ass for obeying the recommendations of scientists on how to minimize your chances of getting it. That would be, it's an interesting experiment we're in the middle of.
I hope we win. I hope science wins.
Yes.
I hope knowledge comes out on top this time.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. It's an experiment in whether people will listen to scientists.
Like if information.
Information. What are you going to do with information?
Oh my God.
And recently I tweeted a couple of weeks ago. It turned out to be one of my top 10 tweets ever. All I said was, I wonder what anti-vaxxers would say to a coronavirus vaccine.
There have been many forms of Freemasonry in the past because men of other days did not have Bibles on their altars or conduct their ceremonies in precisely the same manner as Freemasons of today, and it's no reason for repudiating them and claiming that their observances related to something else because the Brotherhood has always been the same. It has existed under many different names and many different occupations, and that's why it is difficult for those who are easily deflected from their goal in research away from the path. And they say, well, it ends here, so it could not have stemmed from ancient times. It was started in this lodge in England because they can't find anything before that that was known as Freemason. The thread that we have followed has not been the name, ladies and gentlemen, nor the occupation of Masonry, but the principles and ideals and beliefs and the hidden secret religion and the scientific bent of this group. And when you learn to conduct your research along those lines, the path stands out like a neon tube on the darkest night. And it is easy to follow. All the way back to the very beginning of human history, the Brotherhood has existed.